ప్రొఫెసర్ ఆర్ అశోకమణి, డైరెక్టర్ ఫర్ రీసెర్చ్ అండ్ డెవలప్మెంట్, ధనలక్ష్మి ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్, తాంబరం, చెన్నై. ఈ ఇస్ ఫార్మర్ ప్రొఫెసర్ అండ్ హెడ్ ఆఫ్ ద డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ఫిజిక్స్, అన్నా యూనివర్సిటీ, చెన్నై. ఈ ఇస్ ప్రెసెంట్లీ గైడింగ్ 3 రీసెర్చ్ స్కాలర్స్. He has more than 44 years of UG and PG teaching experience and 33 years of research experience. 14 research scholars have obtained doctorate under his guidance in the area of material science and solid state physics. He has more than 150 research publications to his credit, of which 90 are in international journals. He has authored a book on solid state physics, which is an international publication. He has participated in several international conferences, both in India as well as in foreign countries such as USA, UK, France, Germany, Italy, and Yugoslavia. He has been a guest scientist at ICTP, Italy, several times. He is a fellow and treasurer of Tamil Nadu Academy of Sciences.
Welcome to the UGC lecture series on applied electronics. This lecture series is given to the students of electronics with respect to the paper on physics of materials. We are passing through a course of lectures on crystal structure. In this lecture, the contents are as follows: HCP structure, C by A ratio for the HCP structure, atomic packing fraction. Apart from the cubic and HCP structures, we have the NaCl, CsCl, and other structures. We will now have a revision of some of the elementary ideas with respect to the hexagonal closed pack structures. As I mentioned to you in my previous lecture, many of the solids, they crystallize in FCC and HCP structures for the simple reason the packing factor is the highest for these two structures. The packing density is 74%. In the next lecture, I will be talking about what is called space filling principle. As I told you some time back, we talk of condensed matter physics. So, matter condenses, it tries to go to the highest space filling. Given some space, given this kind of volume, the atoms try to arrange in such a manner or such a structure, so that the APF value, the atomic packing fraction, is having the highest value. The maximum space should be filled by the atoms. You use the Hart sphere model and you calculate the packing fraction, that is 74%. Now, in this talk, first I will try to get the C by A value, how to arrive at the value of C and A. You have got C here, A here, what should be the C by A value, right? And for cubic structure, you have got only one lattice parameter. Now, for HCP structures, there will be two lattice parameters. How many you will be having for orthorhombic structures? Orthorhombic, you have A, B and C. Okay. There are structures wherein A, B, C and angles also will differ, right? But in orthorhombic structures, you know, A, B, C, they will have three different values. The angles alpha, beta, gamma will be all the same, equal to 90 degrees. Similarly, here for this structure, you got the C axis here and A axis, A value here, right? So, C by A value should be known. For all materials, whether C by A value is the same or not, these are some of the things which are to be known. And secondly, the packing factor, as I told you, should also be calculated. You know, I told you that the packing factor is the highest for both FCC and HCP, but that we have to derive. These are the things to be, ought to be, which are to be done now. So, look at the structure. This is the same as what you have here. There is a top plane you got here. So, the line joining one of the atoms in the middle plane is the middle plane, right? In the HCP unit cell with one of the atoms in the basal plane, you got a basal plane. This is the line I am mentioning, what is PR, right? And this is the line joining one of the atoms in the middle plane of the HCP unit cell with one of the atoms in the basal plane, that will be A. The atom at the middle plane at P is above R. You got R. What is R? R is the centroid of this triangle, right? You got a triangle, equilateral triangle, right? You got an equilateral triangle, and R is the centroid of the triangle, and this atom will be P will be above the centroid at what height? It is the whole thing is C, so at a height C by 2. So, these three atoms will be at a height C by 2 from the basal plane and above the centroids of three equilateral triangles, each of them separated by 120 degrees, right. The atom at the middle plane is at P, right, it is above R, the centroid of the triangle. So, in the HCP unit cell, the atom is here, P is here and the mid plane, and this is the centroid of this triangle is at R, and PR will be equal to C by 2. This is what I indicate here, okay, this is the centroid of the triangle that I showed here, and above that there will be an atom that corresponds to the mid plane, and this distance will be C by 2, height will be C by 2, and this distance will be A. Okay, this distance will be A, that is from Q to P, that you know for the coordination number is 12, okay, the number of nearest neighbors is 12, that is the reason why this QP should be A, right, okay, QP should be A, and now we can write the following geometrical relations. Cos 30 will be QT by QS, and QT will be QS times cos 30, that will be A cos 30, okay, A into square root of 3 by 2. In the triangle Q or P, QP square will be QR square plus PR square. So, we know that QR is 2 by 3 multiplied by QT. Hence, your QR will be 2 by 3 A into square root of QT will be A into square root of 3 by 2, that comes here, that makes the value to become equal to A by square root of 3, right. 2 and 2 will be getting cancelled, A by square root of 3, that be equal to QR. So, this will be your QR. Substituting for QR square, RP square and QP square, you will be having A square is equal to QR, A square will be equal to A square by 3 plus C square by 4, that is PR square will be C square by 4. So, your C square by 4 will be equal to A square minus A square by 3, if A square by 3 is taken the left hand side. So, that will be equal to 2 A square by 3. So, now we have got ultimately a relation that connects C and D, right. You got C and A the height of the unit cell, and A is the interatomic distance in the top plane or the bottom plane, right. Okay. So, your C square by A square will be 8 by 3, or C by A turns out to be equal to square root of 8 by 3. Or that will be equal to 1.633. So, what we have shown from this geometrical proof is that C by A value should be equal to 1.633 for HCP solid. So, for this HCP solid, this C, the height of the unit cell divided by A, should geometrically be equal to 1.633. This is what we observe. Now, all real solids do not obey this exact 1.633, this is the value that is one normally expects, but of course, This is ideal value. There are number of materials like zinc, cadmium, etc. They deviate from this value, but in general for a ideal SCP structure, the CBA value, this is the structure of cobalt, right, again. And for the ideal value for HCP structure should be this much, 1.633. Now, we will move on to the second part, that is the calculation of atomic packing fraction for HCP structure. What did we do for calculating APF value for simple cubic or BCC or FCC structures? We have to know the coordination number or how many atoms are there per unit cell and so on, right. What is APF? APF will be volume occupied by the atoms, by volume of cell. Volume occupied by atoms means how many atoms are there in the given structure. You have got the HCP structure, how many atoms are there in the HCP structure. Now, look at this crystal structure. I told you there are 3 atoms in the mid plane. They are well inside the unit cell. You have got 3 atoms, they are well inside the unit cell. There will be adjacent cells. There will be above this HCP, there will be another cell. Below that and then adjacent atoms will be there, right? Cells will be there. So, they are nothing to do with the 3 atoms. The 3 atoms that I am showing here, they are well inside, something like the body centered cubic case, they are well inside the cell. So, these 3 atoms wholly belong to the cell, okay? That is one point. Second point is, if you look at this atom, now this atom, that the atom at the mid plane, in the top plane as well as in the bottom plane, this atom, there will be another cell here, right? So, this atom will be shared by another cell. So, the contribution of this to the cell will be 1 by 2. The reason being, this will be shared by only by another cell, a cell above this. Similarly, for the atom here, there will be one below this. So, the contribution of this cell, this atom to the cell, or the contribution of this atom to this cell will be 1 by 2. So, the atoms at the middle of the top plane, and this atom I mean, and the atom here, the middle of the bottom plane, they contribute 1/2, whereas all the 3 atoms that are well inside, they wholly belong to a cell. The contribution of this will be 1/2, the contribution of this will be 1/2. So, we have exhausted that atoms here, atoms here. What about the atoms at the corners of the hexagon? So, at the corners of the hexagon, so this will be shared by cells here and so on. So, cells here, and the contribution coming from this hexagon, square lattice, you take a 2-dimensional plane or solid, in which case you can have squares. Your atom at the corner will be distributed uniformly, 1/4 going to a cell, right, because a circle will be a meeting point for the 4 cells which are of the same size, okay, 4 squares. So, 1/4 will go, okay. In the cubic case, 1/8. Now, similarly here, 1/6 will come from each atom. So, the APF value for the HCP structure, for determining this, the number of atoms in the unit cell for the HCP structure is to be found following the steps which are given here. Contribution of 6 atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, there are 6 atoms here, right, 1 on the top plane. So, that will be the contribution coming from each atom, there will be 3 in the same plane, 3 above, right. So, this will be a meeting point of 3 cells, adjacent cells, okay. Then there will be 3 above. So, 6 is a meeting point which shall belong to 6 cells of this kind. Therefore, the contribution that will go to this cell will be 1 by 6. There are 6 atoms at the 6 corners. So, 6 into 1 by 6 will be equal to 1. The contribution, as I told you, coming from the atom at the center of the top plane is 1/2. The bottom plane is also 1/2. Then the 3 atoms in the middle plane, that will be 3. So, similarly, contribution of 6 atoms at the corners of the basal plane, from the top plane, 6 into 1 by 6, bottom plane, 6 into 1 by 6, that is what I am showing here. And top plane, the atom at the center is 1/2, bottom plane, the center of the atom at the bottom plane is half. So, total number of atoms you count the sum up. So, 3 plus 1 4, 5 plus 1 6. The total number of atoms that belong to the cell, you have to add up all the things, that will be equal to 6. 3 in the middle plane, half in the bottom plane, half in the atom at the top plane, that makes 4. Now, 6 corners in the top plane will give 1, 6 corners in the bottom plane will give 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6. So, the number of atoms that will be possessed the unit cell of HCP structure is 6, ok. That should be borne in mind, this is important, right. The total number of atoms which will belong to a cell will be 6. So, having known the number of atoms, we will now, using the CBA value that we have calculated, we will do the calculation of APF after the break. Welcome back after the break. We have been discussing about HCP structures. An ideal HCP structure will have a CBA value which will be equal to 1.633, that is what I told you, the geometrical proof tells you that should be the value. Secondly, we have been trying to calculate the number of atoms that will be possessed by a unit cell, that will belong to a unit cell, that we showed as 6. So, the cell volume is given by, how will you determine the cell volume? Why should you know the cell volume? Because the atomic packing factor is nothing but the volume occupied by the 6 atoms. You have got 6 atoms in a case of HCP unit cell, 6 atoms divided by the volume of cell. The volume of cell is A cube in a case of cubic structures. Now, in this case, you got both C and D, right? The two lattice parameters, one is the C and other is E. Now, we have to determine what? The area of the plane, the area of the top plane or the bottom plane multiplied by this C, right? Now, you got the equilateral triangles, ok. That you have to 6 triangles will be there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, the 6 triangles, the area of each triangle that gives the area of the top plane multiplied by C will give you the volume of the plane. So, I have to determine the volume occupied by 6 atoms that will be contained by the cell, that divided by the volume of cell will give you the atomic packing fraction. So, the cell volume is given by the product of the area of the basal plane and the height of the unit cell. The area of the basal plane is the area of the 6 equilateral triangles as I told you just now. So, we have to determine the, for that we have to go back to the same old diagrams, right, the, because we are talking about the basal plane, ok, the equilateral triangle and all. So, that is the reason why I am showing this picture once again, and again we have to have only one lattice parameter, either C or A, so that it is the CBA value should be known. Otherwise, you have to cancel, you have to express C in terms of A or A in terms of C, so that you obtain a definite number for the atomic packing fraction. So, I am showing the basal plane. Let us have a diversion in the sense that this slide shows that the HCP unit cell will have an ideal value 1.633, that is the ideal value, right. In reality, CBA value shows sometimes large deviations from the ideal value. For zinc and cadmium, the values are 1.861, that is for zinc. For cadmium, it is 1.886 as against the expected value 1.633. In general, many cases the value of CBA will not be exactly 1.63. The above ideal value for CBA will be used for calculating the cell volume. For calculating cell volume for our purposes, I will be using the ideal CBA value. And so, this slide I am showing to show that I am going to use the relation CBA is equal to 1.633 in order to calculate cell volume. Not only that, I am also trying to show that not all materials they obey the geometrical relation that we had. The ideal value of C by A is not obeyed by all materials. There are systems like zinc, cadmium, whose C by A value they deviate much from the expected value of 1.633. Okay. So, let me now go to the calculation of the atomic packing fraction. It is very simple. What should I do? I should do the number of atoms is 6, that multiplied by the volume of each atom. So, volume of atoms by volume of cell, right. I should know the volume of cell, that is area of the top plane multiplied by C. So, the cell volume is given by the product of the area of the basal plane or top plane and the C axis and the height of the unit cell, namely C. The area of the basal plane is nothing but the area of the 6 equilateral triangles. Area of each triangle will be this much, A by 2 into square root of 3 by 2 into A. So, that comes to be 3 by 4 times A square, that gives the area of each equilateral triangle. You want each equilateral triangle, the distance is A, you can easily show that the triangle will have a area will be square root of 3 by 4 A square, that will be area of each triangle. So, you have to multiply this by 6, that gives the total area. Okay. So, the volume of cell is I have multiplied 6 times this root 3 by 4 times A square, area of each triangle multiplied by 6. This gives the area of the top plane multiplied by the C axis, the height C, that gives the volume. Okay. That comes out to be 6 into square root of 3 by 4 A square. Now, what I am doing is I have C multiplied by A square. Now, C by A is square root of 8 by 3, okay, multiplied by A. I am making use of the relation C by A is square root of 8 by 3, okay, C by A is square root of 8 by 3, that is what I am doing. A is again remaining here, right. Understand that I have C, I have got A here. In the hot sphere model, what I will do is I have an atom here, I have got atom, the two atoms will be touching each other. So, this A will be equal to 2R, right. A will be equal to 2R because the two spheres, the hot spheres will be touching each other, they are the nearest neighbors. So, this sphere and I mean another sphere. So, 2R will be equal to A, that is what I have written here. So, R will be equal to A by 2. So, I will now write APF will be the volume occupied by 6 atoms, right. 6 into 4 by 3 pi into R cube. R is A by 2, so A by 2 whole cube, right. 6 into the volume of each atom. Volume of each atom means sphere 4 by 3 pi R cube, R is A by 2, so A by 2 whole cube. Now, this gives the volume of the unit cell, that is 6 times square root of 3 by 4 into A cube into 8 by 3 to the power of half, that gives the volume of the cell, okay, that will be equal to square root of 2 pi by 6, that works out to be 0.74. So, in the hot sphere model as has been used in the other cubic structures, in the hexagonal closed pack structure, the atomic packing fraction works out to be 0.74. The significant point to be noted is the value APF which is equal to 0.74 is possessed by not only HCP structure, but also by FCC structure. As I have been repeatedly telling, the APF value, if it is highest, then that is more preferred. So, most of the solids will try to go to more condensed state. So, the space filling principle demands the space to be occupied to the maximum extent. So, solids will have a tendency to go to those structures for which the APF value is the highest. Now, these things are not very clearly given in very many sources. Therefore, the thing to be understood, the space filling principle is important. One of the factors that governs the formation of crystal structures. In the lectures to come, I will give you the factors that govern the formation of solids, right. There I will come back to this space filling principle once again, but the point I want to tell you now is most of the solids in the periodic table will go either to FCC or HCP, and the point to be remembered is both these structures have the same packing fraction, namely 0.74 or 74% of the cell volume is occupied by the atoms under the hard sphere approximation. Okay. Then we go to some of the more commonly occurring crystal structures. There are many structures, right, many complex and complicated solids are there. You can look at a periodic table for looking at the elemental solids and their crystal structures. Then you go to binary compounds like NaCl or MgCl2 or cesium chloride, a binary system, or you can go to ternary systems or quaternary systems, and therefore there will be many structures, right. Let us look at some of the simple structures like NaCl structure. Now, because we have been studying over and over about the ionic bonding, right, the bonding and structure, they are interconnected. So, NaCl structure, familiar B1 structure as it is called, the lattice is face centered cubic. Whatever the basis, I showed you very clearly in one of the lectures, if it is simple aluminum, then you have a lattice, you have got a monatomic solid, only aluminum, that is only one kind of atom. So, at the lattice point, you can put the atom, right, aluminum atom. Then nickel is again FCC, right. So, at the lattice point, FCC lattice point, you can put the nickel atom. But here, even though I call it a FCC, there are only 14 lattices, NaCl is crystallizing in the FCC structure, but the basis is what? Basis is not one atom, you got Na ion and Cl ions. So, the structure consists of two interpenetrating FCC sublattices. You think of two sublattices, one containing Na, another containing Cl. Why should you consider two sublattices? Because you have got two ions, about every lattice point you have to put two ions, the lattice point Cl and Na, the next lattice point Cl, Na, and so there are two sublattices. You can connect Na ion alone, that will be a lattice, connect Cl ion alone, that will be another sublattice. So, lattice points on one sublattices are occupied by Na ions, whereas the other sublattice will hold the Cl ions. Okay. They are separated by 1/2 of the body diagonal of the unit cube. The basis will be one atom, Na will be 0, 0, 0, Cl should be half the coordinates, right. Half means what? Half times A, right. In the crystal, each ion is surrounded by 6 nearest neighbors of the opposite charge. So, these are the positions of the ions in NaCl. Generally, if you tell in a very elementary level, NaCl is crystallizing FCC structure. Now, you have seen the FCC structure, you have got I showed you just now, atoms at the corners and the face centers. Now, this looks to be very complicated, right. You do not see any FCC structure. The reason the complicated arises because of the fact that the basis contains not a single atom, but two ions, Na ion and Cl ion. You have got a one Na ion here and the Cl ion here. Okay. And alternately, you have got smaller ion should be sodium and bigger should be chlorine. Obviously, the 10 electrons, Na has given an electron. So, the 18, it has a chlorine accepted electron. So, there will be chlorine, the Na, Cl, Na, Cl and so on. Okay. So, sodium chloride crystal with a FCC space lattice. So, the basis consists of two ions, as I told you. One will be at 0, 0, 0, the other shifted along the body diagonal by 1/2, 1/2, 1/2, okay, times A. Lattice contour of NaCl is 5.62 angstroms. This is what I showed you just now, in order that the students understand in a better manner how, what is the basis and so on. You have got a space lattice. If you have got a monatomic solid, you can put one atom at each and every lattice point, right. If you have got a diatomic, two kinds of atoms or two kinds of ions, then you have got a problem, right. you have to have atom A and atom B, right? Above the lattice point you have to put the two ions, right? Or two, the basis contains two atoms or two ions, okay? So that should be clearly understood. So the basis consists of Na and Cl atoms, okay? Then you have to pass on to Cs Cl lattice. Without doing much ado, I will show the Cs Cl lattice will have this kind of structure. Let me now go to the summary part of this lecture. Many elemental solids crystallize in FCC and HCP structures. The ideal C by A value for HCP structure should be 1.633. APF value for HCP structures is 0.74. NaCl crystallizes in the FCC structure. The questions are as follows. What is the ideal value of C by A for HCP lattice? Name elements whose C by A values show large deviations. What are the crystal structures of NaCl and CsCl? What is the basis of NaCl? With this we come to the end of this lecture. The rest of the things with regard to symmetry and piezoelectricity, connection between symmetry and properties of materials, we will see in the lectures to come. Thank you.